This week on CPTV, students take to the dance floors of the halls of St. George for Prom 2017. The Stray Dogs Improv group prepares for their spring show, and the boys lacrosse team takes on Concordia Lutheran. Hi, I'm Jack Gardner.
And I'm Ashley Reed.
Welcome to CPTV. Samantha Winters will be here with your 5-day weather forecast, and Reese Groppentine will bring us CP sports highlights.
Here's what's happening at Crown Point High School.
On Saturday, CPHS held their annual prom at the halls of St. George, with this year's theme being an enchanted evening. Students started the day with the grand march in the school gymnasium, and then headed to the halls of St. George for the weekend's main event, the dance. Almost 800 students attended this year's dance, with seniors Sophia Alessia and Caleb Skibby being crowned prom queen and king, respectively. If you haven't already signed up for the CPHS Heart Walk, you still have time, as the event is being held this Friday from 5 to 8 p.m. at the track and football field. Funds raised from the walk will not only go to the American Heart Association, but will also benefit the Biomed and Code Red clubs by allowing them to introduce new educational experiences and opportunities.
Last Thursday, Student Council hosted their biannual dodgeball tournament in the Fieldhouse to support the dance marathon. 16 teams participated in the tournament, with the Dick and Janes and the Rusty Rackets making it to the final round. Ultimately, the Rusty Rackets could not keep up as the Dick and Janes stole the win. Additionally, it's not too late to sign up for Student Council's annual dance marathon. You can sign up in Mrs. Fano's room C114 or simply donate. The marathon will take place Friday, May 12th from 5 to 11 p.m. in the cafeteria. Proceeds will go to support Ann and Robert H. Lurie's Children's Hospital of Chicago. Spring weather engulfed the region last weekend with temps in the 70s and bright blue skies. Here's CPTV's Samantha Winters with your 5-day weather forecast.
This past weekend, the warm temps and sunny skies made it easy to enjoy prom festivities. But it looks like temps are going to retreat a little bit and rain will make its way into the forecast. Before we look at the 5-day, let's take a look at what you can expect for the rest of the day. Around noon, expect temps around 72 degrees with mostly cloudy skies. As the afternoon progresses, shower and storms will push their way into the region and temps will hit a high of 77 before they drop this evening. Looking into the long-range forecast, tomorrow's skies will clear but temps will remain in the upper 50s. Friday high will jump into the 60s, but we do see a chance of rain throughout the day. Heading into the weekend, Saturday temps will drop to mid-50s with a lot of rain in the forecast. Sunday temps will jump up to 70, but again we will see more rain and a chance of thunderstorms. When we come back to school on Monday, expect a high of 57 degrees and yet another chance of rain. And that's your 5-day forecast. Enjoy the rest of your week.
Remember, registration for summer school courses as well as summer gym is open until Friday, May 12th. Be sure to email your guidance counselors for additional information on registration. The boys' golf team competed against teams from around Indiana and Missouri this past weekend. Here's Reese Graffentine with your CP Sports highlights.
Last Saturday, the boys' golf team attended Lake Central's Midwest Classic held at Sandy Pines Golf Club. Teams from around the region toured the course with golfers from around Indiana and two from Missouri. Crown Point was 10th with a score of 348. Yanni Costoros led the team with a score of 82. The girls' tennis team left Chesterton scoreless 5-0 at home this past Thursday. Cece Maginot, Carly Subchuk, and Anna Maximovich were all single players that scored in this match. Also, both doubles teams won as well. The team also took the trip out to Mishawaka this past Saturday to face Penn. Holly Riley and Olga Ellick were all doubles winners, but the Lady Bulldogs lost this one 3-2. The next home match is tomorrow night against Lake Central starting at 4:15. Following the program's first win against Penn, the lacrosse team traveled to Culver on Friday to take on the number one team in the state. Culver secured the win 13-2. The following morning, the lacrosse team hosted the Concordia Cadets. Concordia came out fast, but in the end, the Cadets' run started too late as the Bulldogs escaped this one 13-10. Freshman Ben Zimmerman and senior Brandon Phipps both had goals in the win. boys' track team traveled to Brown County High School this past Saturday to attend the Talon Relays. Ben Zirkel and Tyler Hootsing placed second place in the high jump team, scoring 6-1 and 5-4 respectively. Hootsing also teamed with Evan Bleck to get the second place for the pole vault team as well. And finally, the boys got second in the shuttle hurdle relay with Gabriel Garcia, Nolan Hollandonner, Angel Oliveri, and Sam Gold. The boys' next meet will be at the Kokomo Relays this Saturday. Due to many athletes being gone to prep for prom, the girls were left shorthanded this past Saturday at the Penn Relays. However, Hannah Wiley still managed to run a 5:14 mile, ultimately getting first place. Savannah White was also a standout athlete, breaking the 200-meter school record with a 25:65. The girls go to the Princess Relays at Elkhart Central this Friday. And lastly, there will be a cheerleading call-out meeting Monday, May 1st at 4 p.m. in the community room for anyone interested in trying out for the 2017-2018 season. Please see Coach Frankovich in C214 with any questions. And that's it for sports.
The CPHS Stray Dogs Improv Comedy Group brings a show that resembles Whose Line Is It Anyway? Through a series of improv games, parodies, and more. The group will present their second semester show next Friday, May 5th, 7 to 9 p.m. in the auditorium. All proceeds will benefit the Crown Point Canine Unit. Lastly, yesterday was announced that U.S. News and World Report, in their annual ranking of Indiana high schools, listed CPHS as 18th overall in the state of Indiana. Munster High School, along with CPHS, were the only Northwest Indiana schools listed in the top 20. Signature School in Evansville was again listed as number one school in the state. That'll do it for today's show.
Remember, you can view all our past episodes at cptvmedia.com.
You can also follow us on Twitter, at cptvmedia.
For Samantha Winters, Reese Groffentine, and all of us here at CPTV, I'm Ashley Reed.
And I'm Jack Gardner.
We'll see you next time.
Take care.